Hi guys, it's Haffina. I am back again, and this is going to be part two of my mega haul videos, or the second one. This time around, I am opening this parcel, which came from Pretties For Your Face, or from Meg, or Megan. She is a member of the Geeks and Beauties community, and she has some really cool stuff. And I got some stuff via Omnea when Omnea and I did our swap, but I had the opportunity and the funds to go and buy some stuff, so I might have gone a little cray-cray. I might have bought a lot of stuff, hence why it's in a box. As I said in my other video, I didn't open any of this. I literally got home from uni, and I didn't get home from uni till like 8 o'clock last night. And these parcels were sitting there. A whole bunch of parcels were sitting there, so yeah. Alright. So I got some buff and body type stuff, as well as some makeup stuff. So the first thing I have is the Fruit Slice Fluff Soap, which you take some and you put water in it and it turns into a fluffy soap, and I thought that's really interesting. And this, like the picture on the front, makes me think it's going to be very citrusy, which is right up my alley because I like that kind of stuff. And it looks very citrusy in the packaging. It's got like little specks of green and pink and orange and stuff in it, so that's really interesting. So, interested to see what that's like. I got one of the scrubbies. This is the Guava Passion Fruit Scrubby. It looks, reminds me a lot of watermelon, the like look of it, but it's guava. I really like guava and passion fruit and that kind of stuff. Didn't really have any stuff that was like pineapple, which I would have totally bought, but yeah, I'm sure this will be interesting. And I like a decent scrubby occasionally. I get some dry skin in some places. I believe this is actually a sample, judging by the teeny tiny little size. This is cherry lemonade soap, so that will be interesting to use. Don't usually use solid soaps unless they're like a body scrubby kind of bar type thing. I generally use liquid soaps, but I can always like use it as a hand soap or something. The other thing I got is because I was super curious about it, and I do have a lot of pigments and powdered eyeshadows, like loose eyeshadows, and she sells a mixing medium. Now, mixing mediums are really good if you want to take a eyeshadow or a pigment or something like that and turn it into like a liquid eyeliner, or you want to make more of a liquidy eyeshadow to make it pop more, kind of like how people wet their brush with Fix Plus. You basically just mix it together and you can use it to make a liquid thing, which is really good if you're doing something that's a particular color and you don't have that color in eyeliner, but you have it in some kind of powdered form. You can turn that powdered form into a liquid eyeliner to use as a liquid eyeliner. And it's a huge bottle. Like when you consider that the lit mixing medium that comes with the lit glitters is about that big. So it's at least twice the size, which is friggin' great. And her prices, in case you don't know, her prices are phenomenal. Phenomenal. You should totally, totally get it checked out. And because I bought the mixing medium, I thought I'd get one of her loose glitters. And this is called Holy Wood. And they are beautifully packaged. It's got a little sifter top, and the sifter top has got a little thingy over the top of it. So this is a red, red and grey, basically, glitter mix. Really interesting. Different. Yeah, might even have some black in it. So that's a little different. And then we have some more stuff that is packaged in a way where I will need my handy dandy knife. So I bought a pile of eyeshadows and I bought a magnetic palette because I bought a pile of eyeshadows. So that is what, whoops, is in the first little roll, is all these eyeshadows. When I say I bought a lot of eyeshadows, there are a lot here. So we have Enchanted Forest. Get your butt down in there properly. Don't you love it when they don't want to behave themselves? It's kind of stuck up in the lid. So she packages all of her loose eyeshadows like this. If you're getting them like in a palette, you can get them in a container if you want them in a container. But these can then be put in a magnetic palette, which I'll just grab the magnetic palette from the bottom. So this is what it looks like. It has the Pretties For Your Face logo on it. And it's just a blanky thing. I'll see if I can pull this out using the... Yep, that worked. So that is Enchanted Forest, right? That's a pretty greenish colour. The next one is called Flashdance, which is a purple, shimmery purple. Then we have Deep Space, which is a, if I remember properly, it is a duochrome. Kind of gold and sort of pinky purple. So Deep Space. Then we have Circuit, which is silvery and sort of, I don't know if it's holographic, but very shimmery. Might just be silver. It's kind of got a green lean to it. Then we have Luna, which is the most stunning greenish blue, and it has a pink shift to it. It's like eye-popping when you like open it up, you're just like, wow. I love those kind of colours. And we have a Black Hole, which is not black. I mean, if, not that that would be a problem, but it's not actually black. It's more of a blackened purple. A lot of her eyeshadows, I've noticed, are not like one straight pigment colour. There's like more than one pigment colour in them. Next one is Charged, which is a green, a greeny, purpley, black. It's clearly a duochrome. So it looks green, but then when you tilt it, it looks purple. Isn't that cool? That's awesome. I got three more hiding down here. They kind of slipped out the thing. So I have Ozone, which is a shimmery orange colour. It's sort of like a peach colour. Then we have Galaxy. I actually got all of, I think it was three different collections. so these are ones from different collections. So Galaxy is blue and kind of a pinky red. Kind of hard to explain. Again, it's one that when you tilt it, it looks a little different. That's cool. And then out of that little, I've got another thingy of ones. And the last one of these ones is Crosset. I've literally got eyeshadow on my fingers. So these are all handmade by Megan. So this one is pink. It's a pink to gold shift. So there it looks pink. It looks more gold, which is really, really cool. I am looking forward to playing with these. So we have another roll. I don't think they're all going to fit in the palette, but I have another palette, so, like, I have my own previous palette. So, yeah. I did mention that I went a little crazy. Looks like I might have to repress that one. This one is called Brocade. And it looks like it's attached itself to the lid. So I have to look at that one. I probably need to repress it. Then we have Comet, which is a blue to pink. It does shift to a pinky colour, which is cool. We have On Fleek, which is a green. Just a very, I mean, some could say basic green. But I don't think there is anything basic about any of Megan's eyeshadows. Then I have No Shade, which is a very, very bright golden yellow. Very, very pretty. Queen, which I literally got because of the name. Which is purple, as it should be, because queens are royal, and royal purple is the perfect colour for them. We have Spilling Tea, which is a bright, whoops, you get back in there, and you get out of there. Yes, I'm talking to my eyeshadow. That's a bright blue. That one looks like a matte. I think I did get some mattes as well as some shimmery ones. Then we have Kiki, which is, let's see if I can fit you in that gap. You don't want to come out, do you? Nope. Okay, I'll leave you in. Oh, now you want to come out. Doesn't want to fit though. Okay, so Kiki is orange. I'm going to put Kiki back in the thing. I'm just going to close that before I drop it somewhere and damage them. We have Love is Love, which is a red. Which is funny because I don't really wear red very often. But I saw this one. I think it's actually part of one of the other collections. I think it's part of the Pride collection, because the Pride collection is one of the ones I got. This one is M80, which is It's kind of a peachy with a gold shimmer. Then we have Fuse, which is... it's a greyed out bluey purple, I think. Hard to tell when you can't pull them out of the package. I need to put them in my other Z palette to look at them properly. If you guys want a swatch video of just Pretties For Your Face that I now have, let me know. Then we have Pistil, which is a purple with some red in it and some blue probably. It's kind of like a blurple. My camera might not be particularly accurate. And last of those is Flare, which is a very bright yellowy gold. Very pretty. Excuse my dog. Has decided that she needs to have people pay attention to her. So then I got... I also got three palettes, like made-up palettes, already put together. She sends a little card with her deets on it saying thank you. She gives you a little bonusy thing and a sticker that you can stick somewhere. So those are all nice little touches. Let me just shove those out of my way. I'll find something to do with these little containers. Or maybe I'll send them back to Meg and then she can sanitize them and reuse them. Okay. So, the first one I got is Heart of Fantasia. Fantasia is one of my favourite movies of all time. So, this has Falcor, Childlike Empress, Atreyu, Rockbiter, and The Nothing. Beautiful. I really wanted Falcor and the Childlike Empress, so Falcor, Childlike Empress, Atreyu, Rockbiter, and The Nothing. So this, I had actually put this one in my cart and this one in my cart, and then I realized I was part of a collection and I thought, well, I might as well just buy the whole collection. Yeah, that's me. The next one is the Sugar Rush palette, which is Wreck-It Ralph, which I know a few of my Geeks and Beauties pals actually have. So we have, back to front, Glitch, Von Schweetz, Sour Bill, Taffeta, and King Candy. And I had put Glitch in my card, and I think one of the other ones, and I thought, oh, bugger, I'll just buy the whole collection. And this here is basically a matte cream, which is always super useful. So that's the Sugar Rush one. And the last one, I think that's the last one, is, you know when you buy so much that you don't actually remember what you bought? This one is a highlighting palette, by the way. I was going to buy separate highlighters, and then I saw this palette, and I thought, no, I'll just buy the palette. So it has holographic label on it, and it's not difficult to repress, but one of them's decided to jump out of there, which would be, if I'm not mistaken, the holographic one. So there's Magic Hollow, Peace Love Makeup, and Unicorn Glow. So yeah, those are really interesting. So I might She like really feels her pans, which is why sometimes they things like that happen. Plus they've traveled a really long way. So yeah, that is everything that I got from Pretties For Your Face. I will leave Megan's website, Pretties For Your Face, down below, so you can go and check it out and see for yourself. Her prices are fantastic and she has so many interesting palettes and ideas. So things like Hamilton and Hocus Pocus and that kind of stuff. So if you're into indie makeup, which I always, you know, support indie makers as much as you can. You know, they're small business people, they're mums and dads just like you and I. You know, people just trying to make a living. Yeah, give them lots of support. Yeah, so that is it for this video. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there. Click the little bell. If you want to get notified of when I upload new content, leave me a thumbs up if you like haul and makeup type videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.